idols decorate the evergreen tree. That's another sign of idolatry, and that's really another sign of serving another god. Because y'all love them damn trees. Yes, they be pretty, yet, but you break your neck every year. Oh, my tree, my tree, my tree, my tree. The tree get more love than Jesus do. That's what God talking about, serving other gods. Anything get more love than your God do is another god. Does that sound clear? Because you think you out serving Allah or serving him. No. These gods that God is talking about is these gods of sexual immoralities, these other gods, these gods that is in us, that come out of us, that, you know, they're there. These demonic gods out here that they talk about, the Baphomet, goat, and all that stuff. Like, you're not serving Ra or Jah or Allah. You thinking like that, or Buddha or Dalai Lama. No. These are gods you create. These are gods that is passed to you with temptation. These are gods that you desire to just go follow. But when you think about other gods, it's anything you love more than God. God says, serve no other god, worship no other god but me. And that's hard for some of us to do, because we make even people our gods. We make things our god. We make everything our god. And God's saying, wait. Don't make everything your god. I know you like to do that. God knows you like some things. But he said, no. I'm the one true God, okay? Let's just get that straight. So there was some other gods in this world. And there was some other gods always trying to come in, Abraham and his seed and his descendant and God's people. Yes. And you didn't know Abraham wasn't even a Jew, right? That's how God is. You didn't know Abraham wasn't a Jew? Abraham came from the land of Ur, the Chaldeans. Abraham, God took him out of his land, brought him over here, made him a father of many nations, the Jewish nation people back then. Abraham wasn't a Jew, a Hebrew Israelite, the children of Israel at that time. Abraham was brought from another land, another territory. You don't know that though, huh? You don't. Nah, honey. Hey, yeah, Santa. You worshiping Satan. And let me tell you how. As I was saying, the people of that time always trying to find a way to make these people serve other gods. So what do they do? Have you ever met Saint Nick? Have you ever seen any pictures of him? I ain't talking about the million and one different pictures of Jesus and Santa. Pictures of Jesus. You see like the million, 5 million different pictures of Jesus you got out here. The man only had one face, okay? But we see him in so many different profiles. It's ridiculous, right? I know it is. It is ridiculous. Same thing with Santa. Same thing with Santa. And too many different ones looking around, looking like, hey, baby cousin, how are you? Looking like, different people, right? Saint Nick only had one face. I don't have my phone with me, but I got this other video I'm doing, and I just didn't want to look up Saint Nick, because by the time I looked up Saint Patrick, Saint Valentine, them goddamn Romans got y'all hooked serving all kinds of other gods. But those are those are whole nother video. That's whole nother topic right there. We're gonna talk about Santa, because back in Egypt, yeah, the evergreen tree, they worshiped the evergreen tree. Yes they did. And the evergreen tree, okay, let me tell you something. How come 365 days of the year the Pope ain't got enough sense to say, you know what? Since he was on the TV talking about Jesus as a Pope baby last night, get a Pope baby his own holiday. It costs too much money for you to get a Pope baby his own holiday. He gotta have it with Santa. How blasphemous and ridiculous is that? When Santa Saint Nick might be real, because all these saints we hear about, that you, Saint Cupid, Saint Valentine, they all came from the Roman Empire. Like I said, if I do the research on Saint Nick, I just said I know he got to come from the Romans too. By the time I got ready to do this right here, I know Saint Nick is down with the Romans. I don't have to research that. I'm going to research it to know exactly what he did. Because when I researched St. Valentine's, it said he would go on the court and give out brotherly love. Well, okay then. That explains it all in the Book of Romans. Yo, you don't read your Bible? I'm sorry. I'm going to try to share as much as I can. It's sitting right here. But you got to put that work in. You got to read, because when you read it, it pierces your ears. When you look at the words, it opens your eyes. You be like, whoa, it reaches your spirit and your soul, and you'll be able to discern what and who and why they all said what they said and said, this is the word of God, thus saith the Lord. But you don't hear them quote anything. You don't hear them hooping and hollering, trying to catch the Holy Spirit and running around the church. You see them way down with all this king and high priestly stuff, right? Because when I looked up the word potentate, they say Jesus is a potentate. P-O-T-E-N-T-A-T-A-T-E. Potentate. They say the Pope is a potentate. They say Zeus is a potentate. It means powerful. So they got all these in with Jesus. I'm telling you, Christ is something totally. Trying to tell you, it all ties together with them. Anyway, back to the Egyptians. They have an evergreen tree. The evergreen tree came from Egypt. The evergreen tree is from Egypt. Okay? And it was passed on to you to worship, to throw you off of your truth. If this is Jesus' birthday today, why the Pope can't make Christmas tomorrow? Why the resurrection of Jesus have to be with Easter? They don't give a damn about Christ. See, Jesus, they don't care. Because it's one and the same, Jesus and Satan to me. I didn't say Christ. You got to know the difference. And don't you go putting no words in my mouth. But I know what I said. I said Jesus and Santa is one and the same. They got you worshiping Jesus, Satan, Santa. All of that is one and the same. That's why they don't want to remove the 2 days, because they getting all the worship, all the praise. You shouting, oh, my Savior was born to hallelujah. I don't say that no more. Why? Because the Bible telling me something different. The same set Bible you reading, was he a baby? Was he born today? Why the dates ain't in the Bible? You got dates for everything else in the Bible, but correct dates for his birth. Don't that alarm you as a Christian, as a believer? Don't his resurrection, when you hop from Easter, from March to April, back to April, behind the Easter, don't that alarm you? 365 days in a year, in the two most important days in your Christian history and religious walk and personal relationship with God, is coupled over by some pagan-ass holiday? Wait till we gonna get into this right here. Really? And you don't question it? You just jump up year after year. Oh, I'm gonna serve my Lord. How is you serving him and really worshiping when you don't even know his real birthday? When you don't even know the day he rose from the dead? But the Romans will keep this from you. I bet you they know. I bet you. They got it all over in the bottom of the Vatican, in the basement. I know this. Now I know this. Let me just say, Christian faith, know it. It's a character in the Games of Faith. Go ahead, go to Amazon, get the book. Yeah, I'ma plug it. She on a mission to find out what really happened. Straight out the Bible. Everything she reading, I'm reading, is right there in the Bible. But we go along for this. We just keep cruising in life on their coattails. I bet you if every believer, every Christian looked at this and saw this the way that it is and said, hold up. They wouldn't be getting all, you said, God get the glory. How God get the glory when you run around here worshiping everybody else that's